Hello everyone, earlier we discussed how to share WebDriver instance using Pico Container in different classes. In this video, we will implement Page Factory along with Pico Container. Do watch the previous video or get the code of base class and hooks from ProgramsWeb website or GitHub before proceeding with this tutorial. So in base class, you can see I have getDriver and setDriver method. GetDriver is returning my web driver. Also, don't forget to add Pico Container dependency to your pom.xml. Now, first we need two feature files, new file, first.feature, my first feature file, tag it with smoke test, and in this scenario, we will click on login link of ProgramsWeb. Given I am on the home page and I click on login link. Now create another feature file, give it name second.feature. Copy your code from first feature file. My second feature file, here click on asked out link of ProgramsWeb. Given I am on the home page and I click on asked out link. Now I need two POM files inside my page modules, first POM and second POM. In first page object file, create constructor, here add instance of base which we did earlier, and then page factory dot init elements. So if you remember page factory, here we were specifying WebDriver driver. Now here in factory specify base dot get driver to get the driver instance, and here this. So notice this change and this change. Now find by CSS, then locator for your login link, and then method to click on login link, login link dot click, import find by. Now same thing you need in your second POM as well. Paste it. Rename to second POM. Second POM. And here we need asked out link. Click asked out. Asked out link dot click. Now visit ProgramsWeb website and here get the locator for login, href. So this is the locator for login link. Paste it to your first POM here. Now for asked out, we have this href is equal to asked out. Paste it to your second POM. Okay, now our POM is ready. Now switch to your step definition package. Here create two classes, first SD and your second SD. Now in your first SD, again base, then first POM, instance of your page object model and your base class. Now create constructor. Here again base and this dot base is equal to base, then first POM is equal to new first POM. Here it will accept base. Now copy this and paste to your second POM, second POM, second POM, second POM, here second POM, and second POM. Import your second POM class. You have to generate step definitions for your first and second feature file. I am doing it using the dry run, you can use any other way. So this given, I am on the home page and I click on login link. I am pasting in first SD and this I click on asked out link, paste it to your second SD. For second SD we need to click on asked out link, which we can do using second POM dot click asked out. Now for first SD, here we have to click on login link, first POM dot click login link. Now here we need to visit home page, which we can do using driver dot get https www.proclamswitch.com. Now you can see for driver we are getting error. So for driver we can do webdriver driver, and here this dot driver inside constructor base dot get driver. Now this thing we have not done for the second SD because we were not getting URL there. This is up to you where you want to put this. For demo I have added it here. Alright, so we are done. Now go to your test runner, set dry run to false and start executing your code and see if we get any error, and we'll fix it. Run as JUnit test. So Chrome is launching. Here login test executed. Now asked out is executing. Our test is executed. You can see in JUnit report, and as well you can view my extent report. Refresh, open with . So here in extent report you can also see test executed. Find my first feature file, my second feature file. That's all. In next tutorial we will discuss how to implement extent report with Cucumber 7 version. Thank you for watching this video.